What is up, guys? We are back for a quick look at the brand new Diamond Select, the Dark Knight Returns Batman and Robin PVC gallery statue. My favorite adaptation, comic book wise, of Batman. Now, I did pick this up from BigBadToyStore.com. If you guys want to pick this up or check out the website, make sure you guys use my link in the description down below. So this comes in a fairly large packaging with open windows. I took the figure obviously out. It does have the Batman 80 years right here on the left, and you can see there's the description of the figure. Big open window on the top. You can see the Batman logo in the back in the insert. Right over here, you have an open window, and then on the back there is a bit of a description on the PVC statue. So really happy to have this. And then you come to this side, same thing. There's no other description on this. Let's bring out the statue. And we're also gonna be doing a comparison with another Dark Knight Returns statue. All right, guys, so let's go ahead and take a close look at the PVC statue. So first off, I mean, this is a fairly large display base. I mean, put my hand right here, you can see how big this actually is. So we have the base, and it's a brick display. It looks like they're on top of a building. You can see some smoke. This is like a translucent grayish colored, it has that smoke effect to it. And then you have some more right over here, and then you can see more of the brick displays. There's nothing there on the bottom. And then we come over here and you can see some of the piping on top of the building. So it's got some nice detailing. And then you have the base, so you can see the concrete that they used on top. But the base itself is really nice and very massive. And then we have Batman with Robin, the female version of Robin in the Dark Knight Returns storyline. So let's get some close-up shots here of Robin. You know what? She actually looks very, very good. They sculpted the character very well. The glasses are cool. They are see-through, so you can see her eyes through her glasses. Her little comb over, I actually like how they did that. Very nicely sculpted. The paint on it's okay. It looks like there's a little bit of different colors in there. I'm not sure if it's supposed to be that way. The outfit is very, very bright. That's one thing I really like about this. They give her a really bright outfit. She has the green gloves and the green and red shirt, and this is all painted on. This is sculpted here, but it looks fantastic. Has that kind of like, she kind of reminds me of Peter Pan a little bit. And then you have her shorts here, so you can see the skin on her legs, and you have her little shoes, and then you got the yellow cape. We'll go turn this around so you can see. It is a kind of like a soft rubber material, so that's actually really nice that it's not like a hard plastic. But the head sculpt on her is very well done. Diamond did a great job on this. You have her utility belt, and she is holding on to her slingshot, which is also a soft rubber material. So the Robin looks fantastic. And then we have the massive Batman. I mean, look at the size compared to Robin, how big Batman is. And look at those guns, dude. He's got some huge, just huge, huge arms. Obviously, the Dark Knight Returns, Batman's an older and beefier version in the Dark Knight. You have the gauntlets here, a little bit sharp, and then the cape is something I really like. So you can see it's going over his back, and then it's also draping on the floor. So you can see it's kind of going in front of him as well. I like the detail on the boots. I like how they did the wrinkles. Same thing with the pants. See all the wrinkles on there that they added? And then you can kind of see some on the gloves and a little bit on his outfit. You have the Batman logo there, which is one of my favorite Batman logos. I've always liked the Dark Knight Returns Batman logos, and you can kind of see his utility belt hiding back there. We'll come to this side over here, and you can kind of get another shot of it. You got the Batman logo here, and then you have Batman's head sculpt, which looks pretty good. It's not my favorite from Diamond. I think they might have colored, give him a little bit too much of a tan look. I don't think the light's gonna, or the camera's gonna pick it up because of the lighting. And the red, the teeth look very, very red. Like the lips, and it looks like they used a lot of pink in between the teeth as well. So it almost looks like he's bleeding. The cowl itself looks great. He's rocking the short ears. And that's pretty much it as far as this display piece goes. Let's go ahead and do a comparison. So what you're looking at right here is almost, they're kind of like similar pieces, except this one was from the Dark Knight Strikes Again. We have the old school DC Direct Batman and Robin statue. I mean, this is another great piece. This is something I actually just picked up not too long ago, something I'm really happy that I have in the collection. Again, fantastic piece. This is actually a statue though. This one's more of a PVC statue, but you can kind of see, you know, the differences in the two. Fantastic pieces. Both of them are great. One of them is like a $50 to $60 range. This one's going to cost you probably, right now, probably over $100 to maybe $150, depending on how you find it or where you get it from. But there is a comparison with the two. And then obviously, it's awesome to still have both in your collection because of the coloring on Batman's suit. They both have a different color suit, but they're both very, very massive statues. Fantastic. There you have it, guys. There is my review. Today, we're taking a look at the brand new Diamond Select PVC Gallery statue, The Dark Knight Returns, Batman and Robin. This is definitely going to be in, you know, this is going to be in your collection if you're a big Batman fan, or like me, you're a big The Dark Knight Returns fan. I'm a fan of Batman and The Dark Knight Returns, so I had to get this in the collection, and I just love it, especially for the price point. If you're, you know, shopping on a budget for a statue and you're looking for a nice Dark Knight Returns statue, this is definitely going to be right up your alley. It's very detailed, and the display base, like I said, is very, very big. It's a big display base. The figures itself are pretty massive, especially Batman. But you guys in the comments below, let me know, is this a pickup? Is it a pass? Thumbs up the video. We'll see you guys soon for more reviews. Later.
Well, subscribe.